Thank you, Dave. Well, forget the robins. It is one of the surest signs of spring when outdoor design and lifestyle expert and CityLine regular Carson Arthur is in the BT studio this morning. He's here with tips for new homeowners on the biggest newbie mistakes people make when it comes to outdoor spaces and how to avoid them. Welcome to you.
Thank you. I love that you said I bring in spring.
Well, you
Yay.
Do.
How is that for a good plug?
And it's you pretty much should be just scheduled after the May long weekend every year because that's kind of when we market here in Calgary.
I'm in. I'm all for it. Now, this year we're talking a little bit about Calgary mistakes.
Okay.
Because I've been seeing a lot of the reports that have been coming up right now about what Calgarians are doing wrong.
And this is a little bit specific to us.
This is specific to you. I did my research about what's going on wrong here.
Okay.
All right, so let's talk about some of the fun stuff first.
Okay.
We have a lot of first-time homeowners in the marketplace
sure.
right now. Millennials are buying, they're shopping. Let's just have a fun little tool question right off the top.
Okay.
Which of these is a shovel and which is a spade?
This is a spade and this is a shovel.
And why do you think that?
Because it's shaped like, because that's, I don't know,
yeah, and
that's shaped like a spade.
And you know what? You're wrong. And that's
no!
the best part. Everybody
what?
Thinks this is a spade because it looks like a spade in a deck of cards. No, this is a shovel. This is a spade.
How is that a spade?
Because it's got a flat edge.
I'm not going to argue with you, though.
I'm the expert, trust me. Now, a spade is used
really?
For digging trenches or actually doing edging. The shovel is used for planting. This is what you want for planting because it creates a cone-shaped hole when you're putting your plants in the ground. This is the one you want,
That's
people.
A shovel.
Get a shovel, not a spade. All right. This
Who
is
going to
be a really bad year for mosquitoes.
Great.
We knew after the flood that, you know, we've had lots of problems here.
Sure.
What's the best way to get rid of mosquitoes in your backyard?
Run fast.
Yeah, fly swatters, people said, bug spray. No, this is one new technology that I'm so excited to share with you. It's called the Green Strike Mosquito Catcher. And basically what it does is it creates a pond-like environment right here. So mosquitoes
right.
come in and they lay their eggs, and then every 3 days it drains them. What we didn't realize was each mosquito lays about 30,000 eggs.
Oh.
So this little baby can reduce your mosquito population in your backyard by up to 70%.
Okay, that's huge.
Isn't that amazing? It stops the cycle because it drains the eggs out through a filter system. No more mosquitoes.
That is an
Yay.
Absolutely nauseating statistic.
Isn't that scary?
Yes.
And it's going to be a bad year, people, so be prepared. Now let's talk about power tools. All right, what's stronger, gas or battery?
I have no idea.
I love that. Most people don't.
No.
Everybody assumes gas, but you have no measurement on a gas-powered tool. The truth is, the new 40-volt technology from Black & Decker is actually stronger. This is a 40-volt battery, all right? This powers this lawnmower.
Okay, and that's a big sucker right there.
That's huge. That's
yeah.
awesome. This is a fantastic new type of lawnmower. It's called the AutoSense technology. It's powered by a 40-volt battery, this guy right here. This battery also powers your string trimmer, your
mm-hmm.
chainsaw, everything. So you have the same strength across all of your tools,
right.
stronger than any gas.
There you go.
Isn't that brilliant? But people don't know that, and they think, oh, I've got a big lawn, I should go buy gas. No, not true.
This seems much more convenient anyway.
Easy, absolutely.
Right?
How much money should you spend outside right now?
Why are you testing me like
this?
This
is the fun
part.
Yay.
You didn't tell me that this was going to happen. I really also have no idea.
New statistics show if you spend 5% of your home's value on landscaping, you're going to see 150% return on investment right here in the Calgary market.
5%?
5%.
Okay.
So that's not very much, and that's a huge return on investment. But where Calgarians get it wrong is we're putting in these huge patios.
Right.
And the patios are beautiful and they're gorgeous and I love that. But the temperature in the Calgary backyard is going up every year. We now know, after the last 5 years, the average temperature in the Calgary backyard is 3 degrees higher than it used to be.
Wow.
Because the patio stones, they heat up with the sun baking down on it and they get warm. So even though we may have cool nights, during the day it's hot out there.
Yeah,
you can
sure.
feel it radiating. So I want to talk a little bit about this because I know we're going to give it away as an awesome prize.
Okay.
This is the new Honeywell Outdoor Evaporative Air Cooler. And it is literally for chilling the air when you sit outside.
That sounds
Isn't
very
that
luxurious.
Awesome? Yeah, so you're sitting out there. This takes cold water from your hose, or you can add ice, and it evaporates it. And as it evaporates, it's blowing the cool air at you. And it operates on the same amount of power as a 150-watt light bulb. So it's not a huge energy
right.
drain. Yeah. Now, this guy's available at Canadian Tire and at Sears. Great new product. Perfect if you've got a hot patio or a balcony for your condo.
We're all praying for heat, but I think we could use that. Should we give it away, Carson Arthur?
Let's give it away.
Okay, well, this is up for grabs this morning. All you have to do, head to breakfasttelevision.ca, go to contest, and head for daily prizing, and will be picked at random. So good luck to you. No purchase necessary.
Make sure you have a vehicle because it's big.
It is big. See, you were going to test me on that, too.
Oh.
Evaporative air cooler.
Evaporative air cooler.
That's the one thing I knew the answer to. Really nice to see you, man.
Always a pleasure.
And look out for Carson Arthur on City Line in the upcoming weeks. And taking care of our indoor space this morning, Mike Yanni.
Well, Tara, we're hanging out with Wow One Day Painting as they transform care.